Hi boys and girls, today we are going to continue to learn about volume. This is lesson three. In our previous lesson, we found out how to find height, if you knew volume and area, and we talked about how to find volume of a tank. So we're going to continue today. We are going to figure out how to find the volume of an object that is put in a tank of liquid. So, for example, here is some water. You see that? Water. Okay. And I tried to put some food coloring in it so you could see that. So, I don't know if you can see this line, but there's a line right there that I've drawn that is, you see it? There you go. That is the line, the height of the water. Now I have, don't think bad of me, but this is just a Santa Claus figurine. Ho, ho, ho. When I put him, yeah, I'm drowning. Santa Claus, it's really not, probably not a good thing to do, but it is kind of far away from December, so I'll make it up to him before it's Christmas. Alrighty. Oh my goodness. Alright, don't do that at home. But so if you look now, I have a new line of a new height. So when I put the figurine into the water, it made the height or level of the water go up. And if I take Santa out, see, he's just fine. The height of the water will once again go down. Okay, so that's really what we're talking about today. And I didn't make too much of a mess. So, here I have a rectangular tank. See my rectangular tank? And it contains some water, and this black thing in here is a stone. And the height of the water level was 10 centimeters. When the stone was taken out, though, I took the stone out, the water level dropped to 8 centimeters. So I have to find the volume of the stone, not the volume of the water, the volume of the stone. So in order to do that, I have to first find the decrease in height. Now in my example, I would find the increase in the height because when I put Santa in, the water rose in my glass, but the stone is already in the water. And we know that it is 10 centimeters high. And then when we take the stone out, it goes down to 8 centimeters. So the first thing that we have to do then is to find the decrease in height. So what I'm going to do then is I'm going to say 10 minus 8. And we know that 10 minus 8 is 2. So there was a loss of water level by 2 centimeters. So now my volume of the stone, I'm still going to use the length and the width of the tank. So the volume of the stone would be length, 35, times width, 25, times the decrease in water level, which is 2. We say, okay, what does that equal? Well, 25 times 2 is 50, and then 50 times 35, let us see. Okay. Coming up with 1,750 cubic centimeters. Now, let's see. There's a lot to see down here, so I'm going to put the answer down here. 1,750 cubic
centimeters.
All right. So that is how I found the volume of the stone. All right, now very quickly, I need to put up a different problem. So let me erase all of this. And you will see the magic unfold in front of you. So this time I have here's my tank. Okay. And in this tank, it is 50 centimeters by 40 centimeters. And I know the height from here to here is 40 centimeters. All right. And then I have water in my tank. Water looks like it's about this high. Alrighty, and let's see, this will help. I'll erase some of this. There we go. Okay, inside my tank, I have 3 metal cubes. All right, so I'm going to actually. All right, so I have 3 metal cubes. That says a rectangular tank measuring 50 by 40 by 40 is half filled with water. Okay, it's half filled with water. So the water level then would be, if it's 40 centimeters tall, my water level then is 20 centimeters. We know that. Okay. When 3 metal cubes of edge 10 are placed in the tank, the water level rises. We have to find the height of the new water level. Okay, so they're already in. So I would say then the half was probably down here. And now we have to find the new water level, the height of the new water level. You're like, oh, okay. I will tell you that we studied in 2 lessons before what edge 10 means. Our metal cubes down here are 10 by 10 by 10. So if we go 10 times 10 times 10, length times width times height, the volume of each cube then is 1,000. So we have 1,000 in all 3 of these cubes. So 3 1,000s then is 3,000 cubic centimeters. So the volume of the cubes is 3,000 cubic centimeters. All right, so we know that. All right, the increase in the water level then, how much the water would go up with these in it, we can find out. So we'd say increase in the height of water level. Now to find that, we're going to do volume over length times width. The volume of the cubes is 3,000. Okay. The length times the width, 50 times 40. All right. So let's figure that out. We know 5 times 4 is 20, right? With 2 zeros. Okay. So we have 2,000. So, excuse me. We basically have 2 into 3. Mm-hmm. We can get rid of all of those. And we know that 2 into 3, right? It's going to be 1.5 or 1.5. So the increase in our height of water is 1.5 centimeters.
1.5 cm.
All right. Now, the height of the new water level then, we know that it was 20 centimeters tall because it was half the height of the tank. And now to 20 centimeters, we're going 20 centimeters, we're going to add our 1.5 centimeters. So the height of new water, okay, the new water level is going to be 20 plus 1.5, which equals 21.5 or 21.5 centimeters. Okay? That's how you get that answer. All right, so these two are very similar to the rest of the problems that you will have in exercise 22. So you are ready to do exercise 22 on your own. If you really, you know, get stuck, just give me a call or a text and I will talk you through it. But you can watch the video a couple times to get the two problems that will really help you with exercise 22. So good luck. Have fun. Don't stress. Bye-bye.